Man, guys, I just got back from Madison Square Garden. That Knicks game was sick. I don't even know why I'm talking about Knicks basketball games here when the basketball court is actually over here. Good job, Adam. You screwed up. What up? It's me, A to Z. We're back with more Pokemon Black. Last time, we got our fourth gym badge. Pretty much all we did, but again, it's a major accomplishment. We got our fourth badge. We beat Alisa. Tony evolved into Krokorok. Really quick, let me just show our newly evolved Tony. There he is. Look at this guy. And like I said, we got our fourth badge. Let me just quickly show it off, even though I shined it in the last episode. But here it is, our Bolt Badge. And this episode, we are going to explore Nimbasa City just a little bit more and actually head out now to the west, which is where Route 5 and our next destination, Driftvale City, is. So let's check out a few more buildings, see what we got going on here. This building I could have checked out a little previously, but let's just walk in here. We talk to you. I will judge your battles in a battle test. What would you like to do? Let's get some info. You will take a battle test using 3 Pokemon for single battles and 4 Pokemon for double battles. You may not use duplicate Pokemon or health items. For these battles, all Pokemon will be set to level 50. You'll battle against 5 trainers in a row, and I will be your judge. So this is the Battle Institute, if I recall. And you can take a battle test here. And depending on how you battle, I don't remember the exact criteria behind it, but I think it's how many turns you take, how many of your Pokemon die, stuff like that. But yeah. This is just where they test it, and that they normalize your Pokemon to level 50 for this. I don't know if you need to beat the Pokemon League to do this, but I don't think you do if it's open to you right now. Anyway, this building, I don't know if it has anything important for us. Probably, oh, that's where we got strength. I remembered, clearly. I'm using my brain. All right, what's in here now? No, that's not where we got strength. That's where we talked about this is where we got strength. I'm not remembering the first episodes we recorded. Okay, big stadium. And then, oh my, your Tranquil seems to like you. That's so nice. It makes me want to give you this. And we get a Soothe Bell. Ooh, this is actually a really good item. Pokemon holds a Soothe Bell, it'll become more friendly to you. I think you have to show it a Pokemon that has, like, close to maximum happiness. And if you give a Pokemon the Soothe Bell, it becomes more friendly, and its friendship will increase at a greater rate. So this is how you get friendship evolutions easily. Anyway, I now want to actually check out these buildings here. Let's actually go into these stadiums, because here, if we... Oh, there's a game going on, right. I'm sorry, but you can't go on the field because the game in progress. Yeah, at some hours, you can't actually go into the stadium because there will be games happening. Is there a tennis game happening right now? Because this is gonna kind of put a damper on my plan. No, there is not a, oh, it's basketball today. What am I thinking? There is not a game going on today. All right, good. But yeah, there's a baseball game going on right now. So depending on the time of day, there will be a game going on. But if you actually go in here, into these areas, you will find there are trainers. If you talk to them, I'm still a rookie, but I'll someday be a great player. I'll improve by having a lot of Pokemon battles. So now we're fighting a basketball man. They actually have sprites for all these trainers. They got basketball players, they got baseball players. He's called a hoopster. Yeah, he shoots hoops, so he's a hoopster, go figure. He's got pretty high level Pokemon, he's got a Whirlipede. So why am I sending out Blitzel? Because why the hell not? I think Blitzel can handle himself, and if not, we're gonna get him the hell out of Dodge and just send out Will. Because that would be the smart thing to do. Yeah, oof. Okay. How much is Bug Bite gonna do? More than Shockwave did. Okay, Will, go, please. Will, finish him quickly. Yeah, Blitzel, oof. Blitzel has really fallen behind. I even did a little bit of Austrian training with him just to get him, you know, slightly higher level, but he's still struggling big time, man. I mean, Blitzel, again, not a permanent team member. At least not in the... Don't do it. Don't you do it. Good. It's just every time I think I'm gonna get poisoned or paralyzed by something with a chance, I'm just glaring at the game and I'm like, don't you do it. Don't you do it, game. I'm watching you. Got my eye on you. Alright, that should do it. We'll get some experience. Blitzel will level up to 27. Finally, Blitzel is getting stronger. I missed the rebound. Well, there aren't any You missed your own rebound. Whatever. But, you know how I was saying how Blitzel is struggling? That might be ending, because he's evolving. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to the Lightning Zebra, Zebstrika. Alright, Blitzel is finally no longer a weakling. Alright, yeah, we do have more basketball, but I don't think these guys are trainers. But yep, here's the actual court. I actually really like this because they can change the court because this is where tennis happens as well. Oh, I didn't even mention the schedule. So I think every other day they switch it. So Sunday, Tuesday, Sunday, Monday, Wednesday, Friday is tennis. Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday is basketball. Which, I guess, funny, speaking of basketball, the NBA Finals are currently going on right now. All right. So that's pretty much the stadiums that I wanted to show off. I can't show off Big Stadium because, again, there's a game happening right now. So, hang on. Let me switch out my Pokemon, get Will out front. And let's... You know what? I'm going to go to the Pokemon Center. I will be right back. All right, that'll do it. I just wanted to heal really quickly and actually buy a few extra things. I bought a few more repels, as you'll see. Where are my super repels? Well, no, these are not my... Well, I bought more hyper potions, and I bought a few more super repels. You're not really going to need super repels because very soon you will be able to buy better repels, max repels. Which, yeah, if you've played a Pokemon game, you know what those are. Anyway, I think that's pretty much all I wanted to do here in Namasa City. So I say it is time we head out to Route 5, which is where apparently the path to Driftvale is. But Elisa said she needs to do something over there so we can actually make it to Driftvale. So let's head out and meet Elisa there. Onward with our adventure. Oh boy, it's my best friend. I just had a look at the musical theater. It's so cool. Since you're here, come on, Adam. Come over. Come with me over here. No, Bianca. No. No. Bianca, I don't want to go. Bianca, I don't want to go to the musical. Stop it. Let me go. I don't want to go. God damn it. No. Bianca, please. No, I don't want to go in. Bianca. God. Amazing, isn't it? No, it's actually... Hello, you two. How do you do? I'm the owner of this theater. Pleased to meet you. Pleasure to meet you, in fact. Ooh, I must say that you two seem like phenomenal trainers. What do we do here? We use props to make your Pokemon fashionable and glamorous. Do you want to join and play dress-up? To get you started, here's a prop case. And we get an item that we're never gonna use! Great! This prop case lets you store props for decorating your Pokemon. First off, you need to pick a Pokemon. No thanks, I'm good. Now, don't be like that. Please reconsider and select a Pokemon. No. Now, don't be like that. No. Now, don't be like that. I said no. Now, don't be like that. God damn it, I don't want to play fucking dress up. No. Now, don't be like that, please. You know what? Fucking fine. Herdier, take one for the team. We're playing dress up. If you look on the bottom screen, you can take all these props and everything, put them on your Pokemon, and they'll look cute as ever. We did it. I guess I get it. You were expressing to choose your Pokemon's innate charm by choosing not to decorate it. No, I just don't want to play fucking dress up. That's what it is. If you have a Pokemon who can play dress-up, you can participate in the Pokemon musical! Would you two please join us? The receptionist can explain everything. Let us say a brief farewell. I eagerly anticipate seeing you on stage.
You're gonna have to wait quite a while, because you are never gonna see me go on that goddamn stage!
Doing the musical will be totally cool, but there's other stuff I want to do. Okay, that's it. I've made up my mind. I'm gonna see the sights in Embassa. See ya, Adam!
Thanks for wasting my time! This is the Pokemon musical! Don't bother with it. I've never done it. It's dumb. You don't get anything out of it. This is just a stupid version of Pokemon contests, and those themselves were kind of dumb to begin with, but this is really pointless. Don't go here. Don't waste your time. I hate how they force you to actually do this. Herdier, I'm sorry. Just, like I said, you had to take one for the team. Let's get the hell out of here. Fuck this place.
Daddy, what are you doing here?
I've come to take you back home, of course.
Your mother told me that she'd made it all the way out here. Haven't you gone far enough? No way! I'm gonna keep traveling with Adam and my Pokemon!
Absolutely not. Others do things their way, and we do things ours.
Is that so? Then how about you do things your way, and I'll do things mine?
Sweetie, you keep going on your travels.
Hey, who do you think you are? This is a family matter!
My name is Elisa. I'm this town's gym leader. I also happen to be a model. You know, there are many people in this world. There are people whose ways of thinking may be completely different from yours. Sometimes this means you may get hurt.
Of course! That's exactly right! It's because I'm worried about that!
But it's important to keep trying, to learn about the differences between yourself and others, to learn that being different is okay. And you shouldn't worry. Trainers always have Pokemon at their side. Pokemon are wonderful. It's not only how cute they can be, but also how much you can depend on them.
Please!
I know there's gonna be painful stuff like you're worried about. I know, really, I get it. But, like, listen, there'll be tons of nice people too. Know what else? Since I started traveling with Pokemon, I've already gotten tougher. I can totally tell. So, please, Daddy.
Yes. If wanting to continue your journey is selfishness on your part, wanting to stop you is selfishness on mine. I'm surprised to find I'm the one being childish at my age.
The gym leader's comments helped me wake up. Bianca, I'm sure it's better that you take the path you want to take now. I hope that your journey will be fun. Bon voyage. Adam, please, take care of my little girl, okay?
Papa, I'll come home after I find out what I really want to do.
I'm sure he traveled as a trainer himself in the past. Being a parent must be hard. Did I meddle unnecessarily? You look troubled, so I decided to chime in. I'm sorry, Adam. I'll be waiting on Route 5.
She's so cool. I totally want to be a cool woman like Elisa. I wonder how I'll get there. Well, before that, I guess I need to discover what I really want to do. See you later, Adam.
Bianca, you might be a complete ditz and you might have taken me to a horrible place, but this was actually a really nice cutscene and we got to see a nice piece of your character. I really like that scene and I love the music that accompanies it. Bianca's father finally wakes up and realizes she might be his little girl, but she's growing up. I love the themes of this game. There really is a growing up and finding out who you really are theme to it, and that's another reason why this game stands out to me. It's scenes like that that really make Pokemon Black and White the game that it is. So, great scene with what might seem to be a ditzy, annoying character, but she starts to really emerge. So I don't really hate Bianca. I have a love-hate relationship with Bianca. She's a complete annoying ditz, but she's got some good characteristics. Anyway, now, with that done, we can finally head out to Driftvale City. I wonder who writes the news on the bulletin board. Very lonely people. I mean, somebody's gotta get paid to do it, right? There are performance gathering on Route 5. Alright, so let's head out to Route 5. And here we are! Onwards, this is our route that will actually lead to the path to Driftvale City. But once we walk out, surprise Charon! Adam, stop! You've got a Bolt Badge. I've got a Bolt Badge. Let's test who's stronger, you and me. This time, I'm gonna win! So, yup, surprise rival battle yet again. We're just really getting the runaround. Charon wants to battle us yet again. And his Pokemon have gotten quite a bit stronger. I don't remember who he starts with. I think it's gonna be Liepard. Yes, it is. All right, so he starts off with his Liepard at level 24. I thought he'd be a little bit stronger, like 25 or something. Whatever, I'm not complaining. Will has got this. Will is going to quick attack. Will is going to take half the damage. And Will's gonna take half his damage. Charon is a little bit I see, I'm surprised you chose that move. Really, quick attack? You're surprised I did that? Why would you be surprised at quick attack? It's like the obvious move. Anyway. Liepard done. We're not gonna level up. Oh, he's going straight for the Duot. Okay, Kevin, go. You got this now. Just thrust your arms at it. It's actually pretty good that Kevin's got arm thrust because we can just break through that citrus berry that he has, and we can still like drain some of his damage. All right, arm thrust. Boom. We gotta be careful. Oh, nice, nice crit. There we go. Citrus berry time. We gotta be careful because this Duot does know a much stronger water type. Oh shoot. Razor Shell. Razor Shell. That ain't good. Deep Strike could go. I'm not gonna risk it. I'm not keeping Kevin out here. It's not worth it. Just go. Our newly evolved Deep Strike will take care of things here. There we go. Took a bit of damage. We lost a bit of defense, but we'll be fine because we are going to spark the crap out of you. Alright, you got the Zip Struck. If you don't one-hit KO this thing, I will be extremely surprised. There you go! And another critical hit! As soon as I saw how much damage Razor Shell did, I'm like, no, we gotta get the hell out of Dodge. Alright, next up is his Pansier. Jonathan, this is all you. All you gotta do is Aqua Jet the crap out of it, and then you are golden. See, the good thing about getting Tortuga is the fact that it might be extremely slow, but you have Aqua Jet right off the bat, so you have priority, meaning you can deal damage, you know, quickly. Alright, there we go. Pansier done, and his last Pokemon is going to be Tranquil. Yeah, go Tony. I was thinking about keeping Jonathan out there just to give him some more experience, but let's get Tony out here. We can either Rock Tomb or Crunch it and be totally good to go. Let's Crunch it. Let's see how much Crunch does.
Or you can just go ahead, delay the inevitable, like they always do. That's the theme. Every time someone uses Protect or Detect or whatever, I just say that they're delaying the inevitable. Not a one-hit KO. And watch him get a crit. No. Okay, I'm good with that. Mind you, it's not over yet. No, now it's over. I thought he was gonna use Detect and he would be right, it's not over yet, but no, that's it. Pointless Moxie boost because it's the end of the battle, and that's it. Charon's done. Well, you're strong as usual. Why? Why can't I beat you? Oh, there's Alisa. Oh, you two are friends. That's nice how you're helping each other by getting better. How you're helping each other get better by competing. Okay, let's go. And we're getting escorted through Route 5. But. Oh, why if it isn't Alisa? Aren't festivals grand? Life should be enjoyed. Who is this man? This is Alder, the Unova region's champion. The champion? Why would the champion be goofing off in a place like this? I heard that remark. You're quite a judgmental young person, aren't you not? Are you not? My name is Alder. I'm the Unova Pokemon League's champion. Pleased to make your acquaintance. For your information, I'm not goofing off. I'm on a voyage. I know every corner of Unova. I'm Charon from Nuvema Town. My goal as a trainer is to become the champion. Traveling with a goal in mind is a commendable thing. And what do you plan to do after you become the champion? What else is there other than striving to become stronger? The strongest trainer, that's the champion. Becoming stronger, you say? Is that alone enough of a goal? It's not that I'm trying to say your way of thinking is wrong. In my travels, I've learned that many people learn to love Pokemon. I think that's important too. If you play with those children, you might gain more of an understanding. Will you two have a battle with those two? Hey, you two, come here for a moment. Oh, we're gonna get pitted against these children. Understood. But before that... Thanks, Charon. You're a true friend. Let's battle! Alright, so Alder, who is apparently the champion, who is goofing off in Route 5... No, he's not goofing off. He's on a voyage. That's different. Alright, I think one of these guys will have... What's it? Intimidate, but that's fine, because Will should be able to do a sizable amount of damage. Even though he's gonna get intimidated, we still do have Air Cutter. And he has Liepert. So this is a multi-battle again. So Charon now being a lot stronger and having not just Oshawott and Purloin. Ooh, he's faster. Oh, because I'm using Quick Attack, that's why. I keep forgetting how actually fast, That was a crit? That was a crit. That worries me. That actually kind of worries me that that was a critical. Oh, jeez, they're both working up right now. Okay. I'm not gonna bother doing, attacks like Air Cutter. Because in double battles, moves like Air Cutter, they'll hit both Pokemon, but they'll do less damage overall. Okay, Quick Attack. Thank you, Scope Lens, and Super Luck. One Hurtier is done. Will hits level 30. Will is really getting strong right now. And then, Liepert's gonna use... Why did you do that? Thank you, Will. Okay. Will, Quick Attack, and then, Charon, please. Have it kill. Or no, it's got a berry, doesn't it? Or inner citrus. Citrus. So it's gonna live, and then it's gonna attack me, and with that workup boost, I'm gonna get crunched. Ow. Nah, that wasn't that bad. Alright, Quick Attack. Quick Attack will finish you off, and then that's the end of that. That was a little bit trickier than it needed to be. I kinda wish I got another critical, but, you know. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you might just find that you get what you need. I may have butchered the lyrics, but whatever. Nicely done, you didn't win, but that was a good battle. Your Pokemon looked like they were having fun. Young man, if there are people like you who pursue strength, there are also people who are just happy being with Pokemon. There are many different people and many different answers. When it comes to what a champion should be, you and I may hold differing views, but so be it. Let's roll. The Drifveil drawbridge is just ahead. The champion is the strongest of the strong. That's all there is to it. So now Charon's having a bit of emotional mindfuck right now. Both of them are going through some growth. Alright, can I just get past you? Yes, I can. Alright, I'll fight these trainers later off screen, but right now we just want to walk up this way. Now to contact him. It's me, Alisa. Please lower the drawbridge. I have a couple of trainers here who want to challenge you. Okay, thanks. Now watch this.
Real talk? That was cool. You can't deny that.
I got a TV gig, so I gotta go. The gym leader of this next town may take some getting used to.
Do your best, both of you.
What I am is a trainer. I prove I'm right by getting stronger winning in battle, even against the champion.
I know, Charon, you got a lot to think about now after you actually encountered the champion. So now both of our friends are actually realizing that their goals are not as simple as they thought it would be. But here we are at the Driftvale Drawbridge. Now, if you tried to come here without defeating Alisa, this bridge would be, you know, the bridge would be up and you can't cross it. But defeating Alisa, obviously you saw the cutscene, she lowers the bridge for you. So, let's talk to you. A bridge would be meaningless if no one ever crossed it. Bridges connect the world. That's as solid as a symbol can get. So, once we walk through here... Welcome to the Driftvale Drawbridge. Oh! Right off the bat, I was gonna explain this mechanic, but I guess it just showed up out of nowhere. Pretty Wing, it's actually not important, it's just a selling item. But let's talk to you. Sometimes above the bridge, you can see the shadows of bird Pokemon, right? Their feathers drift to the ground here, and when you try to pick them up, occasionally you'll run into a Pokemon. First of all, I love the music. I love the music and I love the atmosphere of this bridge. This bridge is really cool. Geographically, this is actually meant to be based off the Lincoln Tunnel. I mean, because like we were in Midtown, now we're heading back west into, I guess, the New Jersey area of it all. But it's weird how they went with a tunnel. I mean, with a bridge and not a tunnel, but we don't question it. Anyway, so there was a wing here, and we get a Swift Wing. So most of the time you will find items, and the items you will find are wings. Now what these wings do is they actually boost your effort values. You can give a wing to a Pokemon and you will get one effort value in the stat. So Swift Wings will give you a speed effort value. Resist Wings will give you a defense effort value. There's also Health Wing, Power Wings. I think it's Power Wing, or is it Strength Wing? We'll find out. No, another Resist Wing. We'll get Resist Wings, Strength Wings, Clever Wings, Genius Wings. Genius is for special attack, Clever is for special defense, Health is for, it's Muscle Wing. Muscle Wing is attack, yeah. So Muscle Wing attack, Health Wing HP, Swift Wing speed, Clever Wing special defense, and Genius Wing special attack. So these are ways that you can boost your EVs. There you go, there's a Genius Wing. So if you have time, you can just walk across this bridge over and over, pick up wings, and, you know, use this to boost your effort values. So if we talk to you, when a ship passes, the bridge raises and lowers, but Clay controls when the ships run from the start, so when the bridge raises and lowers, it's up to Clay. But I love the music, I love the atmosphere. The music is really ambient and nice. I love it. I love this place. And sometimes you will actually run into a wild Pokemon, just like the guy said. You will always run into Ducklet. Ducklet is a water flying type that honestly leaves a lot to be desired. In its base form, none of its stats are really impressive, and its typing, while in some cases it can be helpful, it leaves it extremely vulnerable to electric types. And its abilities really aren't that amazing either. Its only great ability is Hydration, and that's a hidden ability. When it evolves into Swanna, its attack stats increase quite significantly, and it's got pretty decent speed at base 98, so it can outspeed some things. And it's got a respectable move pool. So, like, it can learn strong water type attacks, it has access to Ice Beam since it's a water type, and it can learn Hurricane, which is an extremely strong special flying type attack in this generation. But it's not enough to be a dangerous attacker. Swanna is not known for being a nuke, and overall, there's more to be desired from Swanna. It's okay, but it's not gonna win any awards. So you can catch ducklets here and evolve them into Swanna, but they're not that great. I'm not knocking it, but it's just there are better water types and better flying types out there, like our friend Will. When Driftvale is mentioned, what comes to mind is the cold storage. And Charles! Alright, we'll remember Charles for later, but we've made it to the end of the bridge. Let me pick up this last wing. I know there's a wing around here. Where is this wing? I heard it. Where's the wing? Oh, it's gone because we talked to a guy. When you talk to a person, the wing disappears. Anyway, I think we're gonna cut it here. I will leave you on this very ambient bridge as we just enjoy the music and just the peace of it all. So next time, we are going to finish crossing the bridge and head into Driftvale City and see what that city has in store for us. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll be back with more Pokemon Black.